एपी असेंबली मन प्रत्यक्ष प्रसार चूस्त गवर्नर अब्दुल नजीर लोपल की वेल्तुन दृश्याल चूस्त आयन तो पाटे एपी सीएम चंद्रबाबु नायडू लोपल की वेल्तुन दृश्याल मन चूस्त टीडीपी एमएलएलंता अब्दुल नजीर को स्वागत पलुकुतुन्न दृश्याल मन कनिपिस्तुन्नायि। चंद्रबाबु नायडू आदेश मेरे को टीडीपी एमएलएलंता पसुपु रंगु कंडुवाल तो असेंबली की हाजरैन दृश्याल मन गमनिंचोच्चु। अब्दुल नजीर प्रसंगिंचेंदुकु वेल्तुन्न दृश्याल मन चूस्तुन्नामु। एपीलो टीडीपी प्रभुत्वं कोलुदीरिन तर्वात जरुगुतुन्न मोदटि असेंबली समावेशालु मन प्रत्यक्ष प्रसारण में टीवी स्क्रीन पर एक्सक्लूसिव चूस्त
गंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे
ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन आंध्र प्रदेश स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव काउंसिल ऑनरेबल स्पीकर आंध्र प्रदेश स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ऑफ द स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर आई एम इमेंसली प्लीज्ड टू वेलकम एंड कंग्रेचुलेट द न्यूली इलेक्टेड ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ऑफ द स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली and members of the legislative council to this joint session of the state legislature being convened for the first time after the general elections 2024. I would like to take this opportunity to commend the Andhra people's active participation in the electoral process. Their inspiration for change has been unambiguous. Now the responsibility of fulfilling their aspirations lies with all of you. Honorable members, you are aware that due to the supreme sacrifice of Amarajeevi Potti Sriramulu, Andhra Pradesh was formed as the first linguistic state on 1st October 1953. With Karnool as capital. Thereafter, the state was recognized on 1st November 1956 and Telugu-speaking parts of Hyderabad state were made into the combined Andhra Pradesh with Hyderabad as capital. Accordingly, a lot of Telugu people moved to Hyderabad. Again, in June 2014, the people of Andhra Pradesh were forced to undergo another reorganization of their state, the most damaging experience of all. The united Andhra Pradesh was bifurcated unscientifically, undemocratically, and without adequate consultation with the stakeholders. This has left an indelible mark on the minds of the people of the residual state of Andhra Pradesh. The turbulence caused due to multiple state reorganizations and the resultant disruptions have deprived Andhra people of a sustained long period development and progress. Today we stand at a juncture where the people have to again take up the task of rebuilding their state. As time has progressed, it has become evident that the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act 2014 does not compensate enough the residual Andhra Pradesh for the loss of prosperity and development opportunities. The state bifurcation has imposed an unprecedented strain on the economy of the state. There are patent inconsistencies in distribution of assets and liabilities, with 58.32% of combined state population. The unscientific bifurcation caused the state to inherit only 46% of the resources. Financial loss on account of loss of Hyderabad city, disproportionate debt burden, loss of access to public institutions, loss of national institutions, Government of India PSUs and institutions of higher learning, etc. Scientific criteria for apportionment were not adopted, while the residual state inherited huge revenue deficit. Debt was shared on population basis, assets on location basis, power sharing on consumption basis, and worst of all, educational institutions with no basis. All these factors led to the structural change in economy, with reduction of service sectors from 51% to 44%. The per capita income too fell from 1,06,176 for the combined state to rupees 93,121 for AP. Notwithstanding the adverse impact of the state bifurcation and undaunted by challenges such as budgetary constraints, infrastructural deficiencies and unresolved issues, the government converted every crisis into an opportunity during the period 2014 to 19. The government had laid a solid foundation for a vibrant sunrise Andhra Pradesh. The then government focused on the inherent strengths of the successor state of Andhra Pradesh, its 974-kilometer coastline, providing opportunities for full-fledged development and requisite environment for manufacturing activities. The fertile river plains supporting agriculture and allied activities, the passing of three industrial corridors through the state, rich natural and human resources. Reflection on the state's performance during the five-year period of 2014 to 19 gives a clear picture of the balancing act between development and welfare. Completion of prestigious Pattaseema project by linking of rivers Godavari and Krishna in a record time of 1 year. Completion of 72% of Polavaram project so that it could be made fully operational by 2021. Prioritization of other irrigation projects, drought-proofing measures, real-time governance, development of Amaravati region through land pooling, construction of new secretariat and legislature building are a few examples worthy of mention. All the milestones achieved during 2014 to 19 were possible because of the visionary leadership of Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu, the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. In this regime, the state attracted marquee FDAs like Kia Motors, emerging as number one state continuously in ease of doing business ranking. Under his able leadership, the state attracted several investments in various sectors. The government initiated development of Kakinada SEZ port, Bhavanapadu and Ramayapatnam ports expanded airports and increased the state road network. The development of infrastructure was balanced with welfare measures such as increase in old age pension, farm loan waiver, scholarships to students, construction of houses, etc. These development and welfare measures led to compound annual growth of 13.5% between 2014 to 2019. While the state was set to take off on the path of high growth, the change of regime in 2019 again brought back the disturbing time for the nascent Andhra Pradesh. The state that already bore print of bifurcation in 2014 was rather unfortunate to have witnessed yet another bigger debacle in the form of inept governance, where the people were threatened and officers demoralized. In fact, the damage and losses during the period 2019-24 have been more severe compared to the state reorganization in June 2014. The government that assumed charge in 2019 started a destructive note with demolition of Praja Vedike that continued unabated till the end of the regime 2024.